marvelous and a great thing, you know. Our God never changed. This your child is a blessing to the Lord. Why? Because when the word of God came to me to tell you that God showed me that you will have another baby because of what is at your back and it paints you under glory. You and your husband told me that you people are finished because of fear.
Not even.
Nothing can cause you to make you to have another baby.
Anytime I want to give birth to any of my children, it was not easy. Even when I gave birth to my fourth child, I almost died. When I gave birth to my first child, because these same people in my family, I could remember my sister called me that one of them was asking her whether I'm pregnant. I was telling my sister, I said, no, I'm not pregnant. I didn't tell my sister. I said, I'm not pregnant. Why would they be asking you I'm pregnant? That was when I had my fourth child. To give birth to that boy was so difficult for me to deliver the boy. What I passed through after I gave birth to the child, even the doctor was telling me that there was something I was saying, blood of Jesus, whether I can say that thing again so that the placenta could come out. When I was saying that, I was saying blood of Jesus, because when I gave birth to the child, I started bleeding. Then I now remember my cousin in Africa, he was telling me about the story. He said he was bleeding, almost to die. I was laughing then. Then I said, ah, God, do you want to let what happened to my cousin happen to me? I said, this thing is real. That day she was telling us the truth. I bleed and bleed and bleed. More than six daughters was inside my room. They were just talking, 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 talking. They said, I have some minutes. If the placenta could not come, I would just die. I would just die. I said, God, would you allow me to die after giving birth to my children? I said, no. The woman tell me that I should be praying. I should be. I was praying, praying, praying. Before they now put their hands in my tummy, about five or six daughters, they put their hand in my tummy, they press it, the placenta just come out. They were coming my room throughout that day. I said, God, in short, be all my children I gave birth to, God really saved me. Because those people in my family, many pastors told me that those people troubling me in my family say I cannot give birth to children. They never wanted me to give birth to child, but I gave birth to children. How many children? I know what I pass through if I'm pregnant. If I want to give birth, it's another story for me. Anything about me, if they don't put my name in computer in hospital, they will just see my name. They will see everything about me. Even when I said I was going to Nigeria, I went to hospital for checkup. The man just put my name in the computer. I see my name. He said, I'm not sure I will go. Am I really going to Nigeria? They hear that I was sick before. That is the sickness gone. Can I go? I said, which sickness? I said, I was not sick. I said, I'm okay now. I said, what kind of sickness? I was not sick.
That is why you didn't believe that you will have another baby.
Yeah, I said, no, I said, I cannot. I said, nah, I said, wish I can. Even when we were saying it, me and my husband will be, there's a way we used to pray the prayer, will be rejected.
Rejecting the prayer.
We'll be rejected.
But I told you people that you cannot reject the blessing of God.
The
that watch is written, is written. When God said that you will have another baby, nobody can stop it. Even you cannot stop it, your husband cannot stop it. It will come to pass at appointed time. But it was too difficult to believe because you have already finished, you know. But God have never finished
because,
in that
life. Let me really tell you why I was afraid to have another child. If as I'm now, if I want to still have children, I can still have children. Why I was afraid to have another child is that I will say, the time of my delivery, they will kill me. That is the only way they will get me to kill me. So I was afraid to give birth to a child. I said, they cannot kill me in another way. So only that place, that is where they will kill me.
But the fear cannot stop the word
that
of God.
That was the fear.
Because before you came into the world, God had destined you that you will have so baby. No power can stop it. No fear can stop it. No charm can stop it. So you must believe the word of God and believe that your destiny will come to accomplish. Nobody can stop your destiny, even fear, even the kingdom of Satan or the kingdom in your mother's place, the occultic kingdom or your sister occultic can never stand against the word of God in your life. That is why God raised you from that family to bring his salvation, to be a light in that family, to speak the word of God without fear, to preach them. Whether they like it or not, your duty is to preach them. Your duty is to tell them the truth, nothing but the truth. Don't have your own. Your duty is to speak the word of God, tell them to repent, tell them, look at what God let me know. Look at what God let me know. So some will believe, some will not believe. But those who believe will be free. Those who did not believe, they will overcome them. They will overcome those who did not believe. So the word of God is true. When God says that you are my daughter, I will choose you. Satan have choose another person in your family. And God will choose you as a light. So it's a battle. You must fight a battle. You must stand on your feet and say to them that no, the light of God will shine in my mother's place. The light of God will shine in my father's place. Will shine in my own family. And the darkness will never prevent it. Because when you say that, it means you are drawing battle, war. So whatever, any type of the weapon they use against you can never prosper. Because Jesus is with you. Will Jesus be with you? Nobody will be against you. It's a great and marvelous testimony about what God has done. I am very happy for what God has done in the life of this baby, for giving you victory over the activities of the enemy to stop even to kill her in your womb. The enemies could not kill her in your womb. The enemy could not stop you not to deliver her. The enemy could not destroy you, but it is a miracle child and a great and marvelous work of God. Glory be to God. I believe that those who are calling and criticizing you, speaking evil against you, those your friends, I believe they will see you today. Some of them will hide themselves, some of them will not.
For me, when somebody tell me anything about this, my friend say, I will not go and ask the person. There is a particular girl, she was close to me. Even people, I didn't know whether I'm from Benin. Yeah. Because if I see Benin people, don't be offended though, the Benin people. If I see them, I'm ashamed. Sometimes, at least, I don't want to even speak Benin where they are because of their character, because of their heaviness, because of their... In short, they are enemy of progress, most of them. Because all the friends I have, I follow them with good heart, I follow them. But at the end of the day, they want to... One of them that was even living with me at home, when I was taking my name, if not you, I wouldn't have known anything. He was taking my name to a different native doctor for no reason, just because of jealousy. If I buy blue trousers, this girl will go and buy blue trousers. Anything I wear, she wants to wear. I don't know why she's making competition with me. She was doing everything. If I'm in the hospital, she was living with me at home. I didn't even notice it. They said if I'm in the hospital, she will be at home. She will be happy. If I come back, they discharge me from the hospital, she will not stay at home. She will be hungry. It was other people that was telling me that I might not noticing it. She don't even stay with me at all when I come back from hospital. Because she's not happy. She don't want me to be passing pain.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
That is the what we see in the friendship of this generation. You know, the heart of people are evil. That is why the word of God said when God created a man on his own image, he's decided to look upon the heart of the man and discover the heart is full of evil, you know. Some of them think negative, they are not. But the most important
thing is... If they see me now, they will be looking at me, oh, God, I really bless you. God, I really bless you. Look at them. I will just be smiling. Say, oh, look at you. You have really changed. You even won. There was a day one told me that. He called me, sir. If not that your prayer, you are praying. Say you are really praying. You are really praying. I said, who can you are really praying?
Say, because maybe what she have done or what people have done, they're expecting in your life.
Yeah, they did not see it.
They did not see it.
All the things that they did to me, they are not experiencing it in their life. What they were hoping for, believing for, that will happen to me.
Yeah.
Now they are the one not experiencing everything.
That happened. It will happen in their life because... The word of God said, whatever you sow, you will reap it. So every one of them is going to reap what they sowed in your life. And glory be to God that you are now live with some help. There is nothing.
There is nothing
like taking drugs like again or going to hospital
every
or nothing like you don't sleep well again or the headache. You know, so God have given you victory over them. The word of God said you overcome them by the blood of Lamb, by the word of your testimony. Glory be to the Most High God and His blessing in your life and His testimony. And I believe that God will continue doing great and marvelous things. While your enemies will live to see the glory and the power of God and the goodness of God in your life day and night. Maybe God will use this testimony to convert many souls for His kingdom. and to let many people know there is nothing God cannot do. If you have faith like a mustard seed in Christ,
faith,
you know,
yeah,
because
faith,
I am not the one that do it. It was performed by my Father Jesus of Nazareth and his Father, the Most High God. Jesus decided to show his power and his anointing in your life because he looked at your faith and discovered that your faith is equal to task. You know, because when Jesus said, see your faith, you can carry. Because the word of God says faith without work is dead. When you have faith, you take a step of work. The work is praying and obeying the instruction of Jesus. The work is to do whatever the man of God told you to do. The good man of God, not the evil one. So what they told you to do, so that the healing of God and the work of God will take place in your life. As long as you walk according to the instruction of God, the enemy will never overcome you. And the enemy will never overcome your faith, overcome any members of your family.
You know, when I met you, you told me that I'm always the prime target.
Yeah, prime target.
I'm always the prime target.
They have targeted you, to kill you.
Anytime they want to kill me, God will just send the helper to me. They have tried to kill me several times. Which I see some with my own eye, admit I see death with my own eye. They have tried different ways. Just that my brothers that died, the last one that died, 2019.
It's a painful thing.
The death of my siblings have never touched me the way that one.
It's a painful thing.
Because he knew what was going on.
No.
He knew the people that was after our lives. He was still dying.
Even your senior brother that died before him have already confessed that these people
everything.
Are chasing him.
Yeah.
In hospital, he confessed it that he saw
they
this.
Saw
he saw this. Your sister saw this place. He saw this place. They are chasing him.
They want to come and kill them. The person that even witnessed it, my brother that died in 2016, he was in the hospital. They said he was shouting. Somebody in my family came spiritually. Nobody seeing the person. He was shouting, telling people, they want to come and take him. They want to come and take him. After some days, my brother died in the
And
hospital.
The same man is
and
the one that told you.
The same person that was that witnessed the thing that day, one of their friends that was in the hospital, he still died too. See. Because of another person's problem. He died.
They killed the young
they
man
killed
because
the young
he
man.
Know the truth.
Because he
they,
know that
they want to see the truth so that nobody will know it.
Yeah, he know that my brother made sure the name of the person that came to kill him. That want to kill him that night, and my didn't know the guy so know the name. He would tell people in the area, so they kill the guy. And my brother that died in 2019, I told him he knew everything. I don't know what is wrong with them. I don't even understand whether it's greed, whether it's foolishness, whether it was. I don't really know. They knew everything. They were still dining and eating with the devil. They knew everything. My brother said I will tell them I'm a son of a strong woman that is strong. I said, my brother, this one is not strong matter. This one is spiritual battle, which is bigger than you. He said, no battle is bigger than him. Then I stopped calling him. He just died. When they called me that I was sick, I was saying, God, I was smiling. I said, hey, another death again. Because in my family, when I called my sister last week, he was telling me, I was asking him, which year they died. He was telling me, we now calculated it. They always, in that family, they used to seek for blood every four years.
Yes. Oh my God.
Every four years, that was how my siblings were dying. But two of my siblings just died in 1 year together, a month apart. That was what my sister was telling me. See, there's every four years.
And that your sister that have tried to kill you.
Even the one that is telling me now, that one too, I pray. God, I always pray for all of them. The one that God should help them. In short, the battle that is going on in my family. It's not a battle that I alone can fight for them. This one is you fight your own. Everybody have to fight their own battle. If it's a battle that I can fight for my siblings, they will still be alive. It's a battle that you answer your own name.
Because you must receive Jesus as your Lord and your Savior.
It's just, you have to make account of to God of yourself. Nobody will make account of. That is the battle going on in my family. I cannot fight it. People will say, you are safe today, you are safe, God help you. Why did man of God not save my brother? Or why did the man of God not save my sister? If only they listen to the word of God and obey the word of God and believe in God, that God can do it, God will save them. It's not the man of God that is going to save them. It's God that will save
them. It's God. Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the one that saved, not me. I am a mere mortal. I am a slave to him. I am a slave to his word and his law. My instruction is to preach the gospel and to whom? That is why I always tell people in my message that I am not the one that answers prayer. The only answering God is Jesus of Nazareth and his Father, the Most High God. So if you don't receive salvation, if you don't accept Jesus of Nazareth as your Lord and your personal Savior, my prayer on you is like pouring water on stone. Because nothing will move.
I told them.
You know, another pastor can pray, do his magic into work.
Yeah, they like that kind of, you know, I've seen my siblings and people that like that kind of a pastor. There's a church my mother used to go then. This church, they pay people to fast and pray for them. That is that kind of like my sibling like.
How can you pay somebody to fast and pray for you?
They will pay people. I mean, then I was here. My mother would say, they have people that will pray. They will pray for you. They will just let pay. I said, what kind of church is that? They will be praying for people to fast and pray for them.
That is a satanic church. How can you pay for somebody to pray for you? How can you pray for somebody to fast for you? So you are the one that facing problem. You must humble yourself under the omnipotence of God. You must see the face of God. The book of Matthew says, seek my kingdom first, all other things will be added to you. I appreciate the goodness of God and I appreciate the testimony of God in your life.